Hey guys, you're in the studio once again with Luke from GuitarIQ.com. I'm here with another little quick tip for those of you out there using Logic Pro 10. In the previous video, we talked about a couple of different ways to get a more responsive amp simulated during tracking by optimizing our projects using I/O buffer settings and low latency mode. In this video, I'm going to show you how to freeze your tracks, which is another little feature that Logic offers that's also going to help free up some processing power when you're tracking and mixing. So this feature is quite straightforward to enable. We just come up to a selected track and right click and then select Configure Track Header. You'll see a number of different options here for customizing the track header. The checkbox that we're concerned with right now is obviously the one labeled Freeze. If I click Done, you see that immediately enables a new icon on the track header. Clicking this button will essentially bounce the selected track out to an audio file so that when our session is being played back, Logic is going to play the frozen file in place of the original track. So what does this actually mean and why is it helpful? Well, basically this feature is designed to help minimize very CPU intensive processes like using software instruments or complex plugins. And this can work in two different modes. If we come over to the track information, you can see next to freeze mode, we have options for source only and pre-fader. The freeze icon over here will change color depending on the mode we have selected. Source only freezes the track by itself without any effects, which is handy if you're using a software instrument or any of the flex modes, but you still want to be able to access the track plugins. Pre-fader freezes the track, including any plugins you have on the track. So instead of your computer having to calculate everything in real time, the effects are bounced out with the frozen file. The main drawback here is that while we're in this mode, we don't have access to any of the frozen plugins, but being pre-fader means that we can still mute, solo, pan, and adjust volume. Once we've pressed play, Logic will freeze the track like so. Unfreezing the track is as simple as clicking on the icon once again. Lastly, this feature may not really be necessary if your computer's not having any issues in the first place, but you can always check on your CPU usage right here within Logic if you want to. If we come up to the control bar and right click and select Customize Control Bar and Display, we can now access this drop down menu, click on Custom, make sure that Load Meters is selected over here, press OK. And now we can see that our CPU information is displayed for us over here. So that's how to freeze your tracks in Logic. Well, that was just a quick Logic Pro 10 tip that I think you might find helpful. As always, leave your questions and comments below. If this video has helped you out, then let me know by clicking on the like button. Also, make sure to subscribe to the channel for more content if you haven't already. And be sure to check out what's happening over at the website, guitariq.com. All of the links for everything, including the other places that you can check the channel out, are going to be in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.